existence. Hey, how did you disappear out on an instance? You got me all driven, revving my pistons. I wonder if she like the stick shift. Hey, count a four and make a wish.
Wish.
I wish.
What?
That shorty keep it lit. Cause if I shoot my shot, I won't miss. No backboard. Gotta sound a light swish.
Go ahead, touch down like that. 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 Hey, hey, go ahead, touch down like that. 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 Like
work the middle, work the middle, work the middle, work the work the work the middle, work the middle, work the middle, work the work the work the middle, work the middle, work the middle, work the work the work the middle, work the middle, work the middle, work the work the.
So we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hell on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock.
Come like a bat out of the hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like a finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent a message. You're the best, if it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess, you ain't scary to me. Heard you was a leader, but that ain't apparent to me. Put dust on you, Vegeta, run up there, I'm airing the scene. Not just like Vegeta, Prince, and I'm an heir to the seat.
I mean, for real. Test the driver's saw so I don't even grab the wheel. S.L. on my chest, but it don't mean the man is stealing. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Ew, think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this losers think the freshman ain't half the man as well.
Are you irresponsible without your money or not?
Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hell on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock.
Just like the hands on the clock, I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't wanna bust. So they boo each other, think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
I hate to break about me and myself, top two. I blow away the competition like a ball of hot soup.
And there's no catch, I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB, I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 444 in the car, my dash. Shake a pick, told them all, you ain't first, you last. Little boy, that's facts, I'ma throw that cash to my money.
You know what, let me stop.
Freaky, I heard a flare gun, I'm ready to race. No, I don't fear none, I'm stuck in my ways. They say I'm a chosen one, to see it in my face. Get this one and I'm holding on, I can't be replaced. I just take a sip when it's Brit. We on track for the win, celebrate the win again. Celebrate the win again. Take a sip when it's Brit. We on track for the win, celebrate the win again. Celebrate the win again.
Just a stone's throw from historic Monument Circle in downtown Indianapolis, we are at the beautiful Lucas Oil Stadium. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the New York Jets and the Indianapolis Colts. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
At their own 18-yard line.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. They'll run. This is Jonathan Taylor. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Now it's Watson. And he's got his man stride complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A gain of of 28 yards there and give him a first down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. They show run with three tight ends here on first down. They'll run with Taylor. And he'll take it across midfield down into Jet territory. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. From the gun, it's Taylor. They'll get only a couple down to the 44. So 3rd and 2, this quite possibly 4-down territory, though, if they're stopped.
Brings up 3rd and 2.
They'll get that one to Taylor complete. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. And now before they run this play on 4th and 1, we're going to get a break and a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4th. They will indeed snap it to Watson. And my goodness, this is incomplete. The Colts unable to convert here on 4th down. And this defense delivers a turnover on downs on the very first drive of the afternoon. Starting position for the Jets as they come up 1st and 10 at their own 43. Operating from the gun, Meyer. It'll find his man on the out route. That's Allen. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49.
He's on the 49-yard line.
To throw on 2nd down. Meyer. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it down here to the 43. And another timeout taken by the Colts. And that's their 2nd charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to 1 remaining. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on 1st down.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up 2nd and 5.
Off the play fake, Meyer. They'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Juju Smith-Schuster. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Jets have taken a first quarter lead. And that is the definition of yards after catch. They go short on the pass, and the receiver does the rest.
Seems so harmless, doesn't it? To throw it underneath, short pass like that. But boy, it gets dangerous in the hands of the right receiver as he makes a move and takes it the distance.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. And last time out, went for it on 4th down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned him 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on 4th down,
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Here's Watson. tossing around. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. That third down conversion, good for 23. First and 10, Taylor now. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47.
Taylor, the ball carrier.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Off of play action, it's Watson. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 34. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Now Taylor.
Scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Down carry, so it's second and 9.
You know, it's not just all athleticism from defensive linemen. Let's give them a little credit for their football intelligence as well. Read and react by them, understood the play call, and stacked it up and stuffed the run.
In the middle, it's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. They'll try to run for the first with Taylor. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the first and goal. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Watson. This will be caught at about the 5. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of 5.
The Jets, 5-yard line.
After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Jets 7, Colts nothing.
The line of scrimmage, once again, the 5 as they get ready for second and goal. Taylor. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. And he's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. From a yard out. And the Colts are an extra point away from tying up this football game. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep, and no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
J. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
That's complete. He's got lunch out of the backfield. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Now, that's one they hate. The ball's got to come all the way back.
So that's an explosive play, a really explosive play that gets wiped out, and they have to start over after the penalty.
Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. From the gun, Meyer. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit. Even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
Throwing on third and long, Meyer, and that is incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Call that a 41-yard punt, 6 yards on the return, and the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, well,
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Chair. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. Third and six.
Third down and six.
Now Watson. As he throws there, incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. 37 yards there on the punt. And the Jets offense will be backed up to start this drive as they've got it first and 10. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out. And they gave up no cutback angle. You know he's trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield. A gain of 4 on the play, and they're going to face a third down.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
From the gun on third down, Meyer. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
He went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
defense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. They're going to try and throw. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. That's a fourth down pickup of 10 yards and an opportunity certainly missed on the defensive side. Now they try the right side here. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he'll take it to the 43-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. A couple of first downs has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. Gonna give this time to the tailback. DeForest Buckner in on the tackle. Now the Colts will use their third and final timeout. And with that, they're now out of timeouts. There's still plenty of time remaining here in this second quarter. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Off play action. Meyer. He's got this one completed to Mills. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts' 44-yard line. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4. 38-yard line. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up at 7. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Now a handoff here to his running back. Just a yard in the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3.
But when you go from 2nd and 4 to 3rd and 3, that just tells you who won that battle on the last play, huh?
Yeah, first round went to the offense, 2nd round the defense. Here comes play number 9 now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. Operating from the gun, Meyer. They'll get this out to Lynch, complete. And they'll get him to the ground, and he has another first down at the Colts 14. Well, they were in search of a short gain on 3rd down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards.
First down.
Here's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Meyer. Looking for Mims, but this is intercepted. Derwin James with a pick. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Colts TD.
We constantly talk about defenders having great vision and being able to see plays unfold and make their own plays, but you also have to have good feel as well because you can't see everything out there. See the play unfold, feel what's going on, and then get to the right spot and make your own play. And in this case, it turned out to be a highlight one.
Fielded near the back of the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this one.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now 3rd down.
It's 3rd down and 6 yards to go.
This time they stay on the ground. And they will get to him behind the line, but they're out of timeouts, remember, and the clock continues to wind down. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up fourth down. Here's Braden Mann now. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the Jets going to get the football first, and they trail as well as we get back underway in this second half. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And no fireworks to start the half. This will be a touchback. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
First down, Jets.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And this winds up a gain of four to the 41. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
It's now second and six at the Colts 41-yard line.
Off the play fake. Meyer. Able to connect to Mims. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts 30.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. And it's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
New York.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And just a couple yards there down to the 17. For the
running back. That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
8 yards to go.
On third down, Meyer. That's going to be complete to his tight end, Everett. And the Jets are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and goal.
Second and goal at the 5-yard line.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. It'll be a gain of five, and it's going to set up a third and goal. They run with Howard. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jet. It's the fullback, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jets are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14.
That ties the game at 14.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Indy offense at the line and set to go. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. They'll run with Taylor to begin the drive. And he'll be brought down here at the 28. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Brought down at the 28-yard line. It's a gain of 7. Brings up second and 3.
To throw is Watson. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown. Touchdowns now on the year. And the Colts have broken our tie as they take the lead. Rosas to add the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14.
Colts 21, Jets 14. Ulbrich Rosas set to kick off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Rosas on to kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They did what they had to do to start this third quarter. Went down, got the touchdown to cut the lead, but the matching touchdown a moment ago, and we're right back where we started at halftime.
Yeah, exactly right, Paul. They had a little bounce in their step after scoring that first touchdown, but the defense gave one up, and that's the problem right now. Can they get better play from their defense while they continue to score on offense?
Here's a second and 2 now from the 33. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. From the shotgun now, here's an inside Gill. He's at the 40. And he will finally be taken down, but not before he gets it to the Colts 24. It's a big play there for the Jets on third down. 41 yards.
First down, New York.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Gonna give this time to tailback. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
He's brought down.
Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice, steady gain.
To throw on second down. Meyer. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
At their own 10-yard line.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
off to the fourth quarter here in week 15. Happy holidays to all. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. A carry by Taylor to start the drive. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. On second and nine, Watson. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. That one good for 26 and a first down. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Brings up second and 10 at the 37-yard line.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. They'll fake the handoff. Now Watson. He's got his man on the crossing route. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. Here's Taylor. Get this just to the 47, 1 yard gain. Well, with the fumble he had earlier, we know how key keeping the football is here. That fumble earlier, probably at the forefront of his mind. Just hold on to this thing.
It's also at the forefront of the mind of the guys who are trying to get the ball from him. And since they've seen him drop it on the ground before, they're doing everything possible to have him do it again. They need that turnover.
Second and nine, Watson. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
Throwing on third down, Watson. Incomplete, nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down. Still searching for that first interception in this game and down on the scoreboard. Remember, they won last week, and a big reason why, they had three picks.
And one characteristic I've always noticed about great defenses is that they want to be the ones that have a huge impact on the game and actually lead their teams to victory. So you just noted, three interceptions last week and they won. And a little extra pressure that they're feeling right now because they haven't gotten those interceptions in this game and they're losing.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. They start the drive with Lynch. And a very short pickup there across the 15 to the 16. The tackle made there by the safety, Derwin James.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8 at the 16-yard line.
Looking to throw on second down, Meyer. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That one good for 26 and a first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44.
The tackle by Derwin James.
To throw on second down, Meyer. That's complete to the tight end, Everett. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. He'll get about four here, down to the 43-yard line. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and 6.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and 6.
Conversion. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
The 25-yard line.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And a short gain here, down to the 22. So third and inches, and this will be the ninth play of the drive. The shotgun now. Here's an inside give. And he is going to have a Jets first down, maybe by about a yard, as they find a way to convert on third and inches. The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds remaining in the football game. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. And it's caught. It's a touchdown. So they rally here in the final minute, and they're an extra point away from tying this game.
And while it appears the heavy lifting was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down one. That extra point is not a gimme.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And, partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the scores, the kicks away. Will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. They'd like to avoid overtime here, so maybe they can work the sidelines. But then defensively, how do they adjust to that if they do work the sidelines?
It's a leverage game. We usually talk about leverage at the line of scrimmage, right? Who's going to win with the ball blocking and everything that goes along with that. But in this case, you're trying as a defender to leverage them towards the middle of the field, not let them get to the sidelines and try and tackle them in bounds in order to run the clock out.
Chess match here late. So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Watson, off play action. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath, because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle, kind of scan the crowd, see if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Now Watson. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he will finally go out of bounds, but now takes it down to the 25. A big play there on the catch and run. And even 60 yards. So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. They run with Taylor. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
All right, my man, this is now where it's risk-reward. Because on defense, you've got to crowd the line of scrimmage. You've got to get in all the gaps, get up tight on everyone, and try and force the field goal attempt here. You can't let them break one big, but you know something, when you crowd the line of scrimmage, if they do pop one, it's going
to
go a long
way. Yeah, I was going to say, could take it to the house, but the magnitude of this possible upcoming field goal, every yard counts. Again, it's Taylor. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go. The Jets going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in the game. On third down, here's Taylor. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down. Now the timeout will be called, so they're in field goal range with 3 seconds left. And right now it all rests on the right foot of Aldrick Rosas. With 3 seconds to go, this for the win. And off the upright, and it caroms in. It's good. The kick is good, and that writes a crazy finish to this one. A little drama there at the end, but really this thing was already decided. The late points get scored, and then it ends on the kickoff.
And I'm right there with you, partner. At the end of the game, they knew what they had to do. Just make sure you don't cough up the football at the end. Just take care of it, and victory will